You've just put in a ceiling. Now I'm going to show you how to put in your roof. Yay! So your ceiling, if we look in our 3D view, and that's where I'm at now, it's 3D view. Your ceiling is probably covering everything. So if I right, I've actually just clicked it. Let me right click it. Make sure you have that selected. And we're going to hide in view that element. So the ceiling is hid in, and that's probably what we want. Now this next piece is going to be a little tedious. We're going to double click first floor. And I'm going to go back to hidden line. And I'm going to go to course, and you need to control click your interior walls. So I'm going to click this, control click all of these walls. This may take a minute for you to get them all, but the walls need to be set to a specific height. So it looks like we got one wall right in here that we need to select. So you can see you're going to have to zoom in maybe to get a few of them. There we go. So it looks like I have all my interior walls, and I need to set them their top constraint to up to level roof. Now we haven't set our roof level yet, so I've set that currently, so they're gonna kind of freak out. They may be go really high. We'll kind of see where they're at. So let's take a look at one of our elevation views. I can choose the east view, it doesn't really matter, but you can see now my interior walls are crazy high because they're constrained to the roof level. Well, I want this roof level to be set at 8 feet, so I'm going to delete that one, hit enter, so now it's set to 8 feet. So my interior walls are now constrained to that height. So now let's go back to first floor. It is important that you do that, because if you don't do that, when you build your roof, they're going to go all the way up to the top of the roof, and it's going to be really hard to see what's going on inside your house. So the next thing we need to do is go to architecture, and we're going to click on roof. Make sure it's set to roof level, super important. And then we're going to edit this type. And we don't need to duplicate this because we only have one roof. Everything is actually set perfect for you. You won't need to change any of these top or bottom one, but you do need to change this plywood sheathing. I believe it says OSB and it has a specific thickness given in your habitat guidelines. Make sure you change that. Then click OK and apply that. Then we click OK. Now we need our boundary lines. So make sure defined slope is not checked, and these are going to be our gable walls where there is no slope on the short wall. So my short side is my gable side. My long side is my side that defines a slope. So I'm going to check this one, and I don't remember what the pitch is. I'm going to make mine 512. You should double check what your habitat guidelines say. Hit enter, and then check this one. I want to make them the same. Then hit enter. Now I'm going to hit the green check. Would you like to attach a highlighted wall to the roof? Yes, I want to make sure they attach, and it's only the exterior. That's good. That means I've selected them all. Now let's look at this view in 3D. So that looks really good. Now if I right-click the roof and I hide it, then you can see that my gable walls have extended up, but my interior walls were constrained to that roof level. So I can still see inside a little bit easier. And that's what you want. So once you have it there, you're all set.